Hey guys, welcome back to our channel Naughty Threads. In case you're new here, do consider subscribing and also hit the bell icon to get all the notifications. So in today's video, I'm going to show how to make this beautiful design. It looks very pretty and this piece I have worked on is a dupatta. The bride is going to use this for her haldi function. So that is why she wanted it to be a little grand. Now when it comes to this dupatta, it has this kind of buttas. This is actually the wrong side, because that's how I have placed. So it's got some nice zari work like this, and some small buttas all over along with the border. So this is the design she wanted, and since I had not filmed this kind of design, I thought of sharing it with you guys. So watch till the end and I'm sure you will love to know how easy this can be done, and it also looks really, you know, amazing. So now without any delay, let's get started. So to do this kind of design, we will need 50 strands of silk thread. I have made it sharp here by applying glue, and this has to dry really well, otherwise it will be very difficult to work with, because in today's video or for this design, I'm not going to use any kind of big eyed needle, just to save time. So this is nice and dry and it's also sharp. This piece that you're seeing here is actually a dupatta, so I have already finished working on one side. So keeping that as reference, I have made my marks on the other side, and I have already made holes here using a crochet hook. So once you have the mark or the hole, first we'll have to tie the kuchu and then insert beads. I'm going to use a very small bead to insert. That is why I am just working with 50 strands. In case you are using a bigger bead, you will have to add the number of strands accordingly. And we'll have to leave it a little longer than the index finger actually, because we have to insert 3 beads. And then I have this yellow cotton thread in the normal sewing needle. Now instead of cotton thread, you can also use zari, but my client didn't want zari, that is why I am using cotton thread. So this process is the same, so I will not bore you guys by explaining. I'm just making 3 knots as usual. And then pass the needle below the thread and trim it. So exact same way, I'm going to tie one more bunch here. Now the distance between this and this is like little more than one finger distance, and then this from here to here is this distance up till the second line of my index finger. This is how I have maintained the distance. So I'm just going to tie the second bunch also the same way. So after tying this kuchu here, we will need these kind of beads. I am using gold beads. If you don't have these kind of beads, you can just use some wooden beads or plastic pearls or any beads of your choice. And then we'll also need some glue. So I'm just going to apply very little glue here. Spread this nicely. and then put the bead here right in the center and give it a good press. Once you've done that, make sure the bead is covered from all the sides and it's not visible. Then we're going to tie the exact same way. I forgot to mention, this thread I have already ironed before I tied this, so that is why it's all nice and straight. So I'm going to trim it and repeat the same thing two more times, and then we'll be done with one side. You'll have to apply very little glue, because in case the glue becomes excess, then it will be seen on the silk thread, or you know, it leaves a stain on the silk thread. So we'll have to use glue very, very carefully. So spread all this. Hold it neatly like this and then tie it. So I have added all three beads here and the thread with the needle is here. I'm going to hold both of these together like this and wind it three times again. Now just to hide all of this, I'm going to add this kind of flower bead and then a small round bead. So leave the round bead and then go back just into the flower bead here. We'll have to do this at least 2 to 3 times so that the bead will not become loose. So finally the work is complete. I did not really measure the width of the dupatta, but I have done 18 of, you know, these, like so much, 18 on one side and 18 on the other side. So it was quite a tedious task, being very honest. So this is the right side, this is how the dupatta looks like, and this is the border. This zari is kind of, it's not gold nor it is silver. So that is why I did not use any kind of zari here. Instead, I replaced it with matching yellow color thread. Otherwise, using gold will make it really odd. So, but the beads I have used somehow matches the zari. So that's why I just used these kind of beads. So I hope you guys like this video. In case you do, don't forget to give us a thumbs up, and also let me know if you have any requests in the comment section below. If you want a Kannada tutorial, don't forget to check our other channel, Naughty Threads Kannada, and the same video will be posted with Kannada explanation in that video. And also one last request guys, do visit our blog naughtythreads.net. where you will get all the designs in one place along with the video tutorials and links to purchase all the material. So I guess that's about it. I shall see you soon with my next video. Until then, bye and take care.